got you hanging from his knees. Bleeding as you're screaming on the floor. Finally, I found some room to breathe. Wrapped around your finger. Hi guys, it's me, WinnerPaul UK, and I'm not streaming soon, I'm streaming now. Welcome to another live stream. This time we're on Warframe again. My mainstream as it is. Give me a second, let me just change my tabs over. Make sure my game's up and running, we're good. Okay, and there we go. Hold on, is it working? Is it really? Let's see, make sure I got it right. Yeah, we're good. Okay, well, I'll drop that down right now, so we're good. Okay, for anyone that doesn't know, I've just started streaming on other platforms. So hopefully you'll enjoy the new streaming on the other platforms if you're new to it. And I'm just in my open live stream with Little Kuba. Say hi, Kuba.
I say hi. We're chatting.
Okay.
Hi, guys.
And also, it looks like we've got a lurker in there, so we'll wait till he says hi for himself.
I have said hi.
Ah.
You just weren't listening.
Probably because I didn't have my volume on. Well, that's Irish Stevie, another streamer. Check him out when you got time. Just remember, if you're looking for some lucky gold, he's probably got the charms for you.
Hey, hey, Paul, can you turn Stevie up a little bit? Can you turn him up, or yeah. Stevie, you turn up really low?
Well, I've got him at 50%. I can sort of hear him, so it's on his input level, or he's just too far away from his mic. If you right-click on his name, it gives you the option to turn his volume up.
Oh, okay, cool.
Maybe this helps.
Yeah, that sounds better.
Yeah, we can hear you a bit better, man.
Yeah, that means that I wasn't close enough to my mic because it was pushed out of the way.
Ah. Okay, Kuba, we've got a Nightmare Inception. I'm going to send you a quick invite, and it's because it's Armored Agility. Right. We've got 2 minutes to get us booted in there. Okay, change loadout.
I will accept that. Wukong.
Yeah, I've been smacking my Wukong about a bit. I was gonna send me a Wukong.
That sounds fun.
But yeah, with Wukong, you know, it's been a while, and I started realizing this. I keep going back to the same old frames. Keep using the same ones over and over. So I figured, you know, what hadn't I played in a while? And it turns out it was Wukong. So I've actually been working on it.
I might follow your lead on that and start using my Ash a little more. It's my favorite frame that I never used.
Yeah, I ain't used Ash in God knows how long.
You are going to capture the towers and decode the incoming messages. I'll be sure. All right, let's get to work.
There we go.
Tower captured. Beginning stream decode now.
Do you know what? If you weren't so against it, dude, I'd be telling you to get yourself what's it? A Dajin. I mean, it's working perfect with me Wukong. My Dajin will sacrifice itself to keep me alive, but then it also prevents me Wukong from having to use its abilities. And then when it has to use its abilities, it's usually because my Dajin's got to respawn in 90 seconds, which gives me plenty of time.
It sounds corny, but it's a spiritual thing.
Yeah, it's, dude, it's everyone's go, you know. I said that, and I made the Jin stim finger.
It's really, it might sound silly to some people, but the enemy have taken a tower. I hold up and stand all from
I couldn't see him, he was stood behind a fucking tree. No, seriously, do you know tree things that you come in? It was literally crouched behind it, I couldn't tell he was there. Until I turned around and saw his head.
Alright. You know what? Maybe you should have brought Oberon, but you're good with the Wukong.
Oh, yeah.
No tower. The enemy has captured a tower.
Maybe I should bring Oberon.
Oh, I've also put growing power on me Wukong as well. Do you know for his iron staff? Basically, as soon as I get a proc on it, then I basically get a nice sweet bonus on strength. Sorry, I'm listening to people die around me.
No, I was asking me to work with any proc.
Yeah, slash, you know, puncture, impact, anything. It works well for anything that takes advantage of strength being a bonus.
Yeah, I love Wukong, man.
We are dominating. Keep it. The enemy have taken a tower. Must recapture.
Ow, I got bitched.
Solid.
What goes even better, as soon as you hit that channeling, you're actually doing quite well because of your channeling effect gives you extra damage.
I wonder how it's going to work when they take the channeling shit away.
I have no idea, man. But on the upside, it does mean I'll have more attempts to put videos up. You know. I mean, I'm still going to tweak Mi Wukong until I'm happy with it, but we'll see what happens.
Yeah, it should be a while yet. I mean, like I said, they're putting it in piece by piece.
Question is, when they put it in, is it going to sort of lead up to the space conflicts as well? That could be why they're putting it in there.
Yeah, yeah, that's kind of what they're like, tongue-in-cheek alluding to every time they mention it on it. Put another piece in. Always mention a little secret something. Not blatantly, but always tongue in cheek, kind of. Say I'm doing pretty good for getting a nightmare.
Capture another signal. Be careful.
I used to get my ass torn off.
Surely stronger reinforcements.
I've grown. I'm so proud of myself.
Come on, I need someone to shoot quick while he's buffs on me.
Who's this leaving these orbs around? What are they? Where they from?
This tower is ours now.
These blue little frost looking orbs.
Blue little frost orbs.
Yeah, it's not a frost.
Well, I'm not doing no. It's not me, I can tell you that one.
Yes. Well, they're on B.
We have lost control of a tower. Tower captured. Beginning stream decode now. The enemy have taken a tower. You must recapitulate.
There we go, nice little buff bonus. So I got the buff from my proc and the bonus from the rhino. Not bad. And what's good about it is the actual buff stays there for as long as the ability is active.
Yeah,
you
see this blue
orb
right here?
Oh, that's shielding from getting someone up. Sometimes game lags a bit and it just ends up leaving that orb.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not to worry about. They'll...
I thought I was the only one seeing it.
No, man, there's one at the Bravo location as well. They do appear every so often, so it's not much to worry about.
Yeah, I just never knew what.
Yo, Mr. Pirate, thank you for the follow. It's much appreciated, dude. How are you going? Ooh, what we lost. Ooh, they got me. You can never see me. Why?
We have lost control of the tower.
Oh, you think I... No, I'm actually on here, and I'm on Twitch, and I'm on YouTube. I'm assuming it's Mixer, you just hit follow on. Ooh, that were a big one. I'm basically multi-streaming, so I'm streaming to multiple platforms at the same time. Sort of trying to spread the winter name out there. Haha, funny love, funny. Bear me a second.
Shit.
We have lost control of a tower. This tower is ours now.
There we go.
The enemy have captured
but yeah, basically, I've got a thing that lets me do all three at the same time. So, you know, I've not actually had many people sort of mention anything on YouTube, see if they've seen it alright on there, so I don't know how that one's working. But it's nice to sort of see some chat coming from Mixer as well, so that's great, thanks. But you know, you can see me anytime you want, dude. Yo, Outcast.
The enemy have captured a tower.
Outcast, what?
Yeah, I just seen there's an Outcast message. My chat looks right weird at the moment. I think it's cost the mod I'm using. Oh, hold on. Let's see if I can get me in time. Got the air.
Lost control of a tower. We have taken a tower. You must recapture it.
No, I didn't know that. Well, it's a good job I'm only affiliated.
We have control of all four towers. Tower West.
But on the upside, you mean, you know, if I ever did get a partnership with anyone, then at that point, you know, it means I've made it. I'm famous.
The enemy have taken a tower. You must recapture it.
But, yeah.
You have successfully decoded the message. Clear the area.
Alright, let's get them, boys.
Dude, you just make me want to pull out a Tommy gun.
Ah, see. Ah.
Good work today. Not only have we decoded the enemy transmissions, we have also disrupted their communications.
I can bring that box down a bit. It's like off my page the way this is. Hold on. Alright, we got his armored agility, so that's great. Shit, man, what's going up here? I can't. I wonder. Boing. There we go. I'm just going to adjust these settings. The actual program I'm using for the chat, you know, so I can see it, it won't let me shrink it any further in regards to its width. So, I mean, height's not a problem. Let's see, so we'll lower.
Should be some simple.
We'll confirm that. Oh, nice. Outcast got all. Shit, that looks weird as fuck.
It's weird.
If I can. There we go. I think I've sorted it. Outcast name on chat looks really blurry.
Operator? Ordis wonders, what are you thinking about?
I wonder if that's an actual setting on pigment. Won't be a second. That's probably something to do with pixels and shit, isn't it? Hold on. 28, 89, 60. Confirm. There we go. We're looking good. I meant to put CG, not G, but yeah, it all worked out. Right, you wanna, what relics you wanna be cracking, dude?
It's up to you. I mean, if you want to get your mazer shit, I can help you.
Yeah. Since mine is already built. Well, I want to get the mazer, or mesa, and I also need the redeemer.
Yeah, I could use that. All right, so we could do some of that. We could also do some amber shit later on.
Yeah, I've got one mesa part. And it's the systems. That's basically it. I've got the some relics for the other stuff, but I've got a few Neo relics and very little. I definitely need some proper relic stuff. I've got the system, so I don't need the H4 relic. So it's the Neuroptics, the chassis, and the blueprint I need for the Mesa. And Neo Z2 and M2 can provide me. Neo Z2 can provide me blueprint. And then that's it. That's all I got. Not else. That's weird.
Alright, so I'm set.
Okay. I'll let you queue some up. I'm just gonna check on my iron staff where we stand on point wise for it. So not yet. Okay, no.
And you said you only really got one relic from that, so you
said? Yeah, basically it is just provide me the blueprint. That's the Neo Z2, I think it is. But I need the chassis, the Neuroptics, and then I want the Redeemer to replace the existing Redeemer I've got. Check
navigation for active. Alright, so you don't even have the relics for him, so we have to go for the relics.
By the look of it, yeah.
Alright. So the Neos. Well put together, operator. Now you're gonna need the Neo Z2, I guess it is. Yeah, Neo Z2, ITH4, and Lith M3, so I guess we can go and get the Neo and the Axi doing Mott or doing Marduk. Whatever one you rock with.
Yeah. Wonder, should I use that duration or increase my strength? Well, yeah, definitely. Alright, fuck it, I'm gonna put another former for a D polarity. Because either way I'm still gonna need a D. Alright, so if I put that on there, I'll put a Vitality 9. That'll do as a temporary measure. So still got the best of both.
What's your mod?
Wukong. I'm sort of tweaking it. I'm going to make myself an extra Wukong. But at this point, I'm sort of tweaking my Wukong to try and work out what I think is going to be a good build for him. For my preference. And then when I get another one, I'm just going to basically mod it up and I'm good. This one's going to be like the waste. I forgot what they're called. Former. It's the waste former build. So I'll waste as many former as needed until I'm happy with what I've got, and then I'll build a brand new one and use only what I need to.
The old build from a long time. Using wow. I don't think he has anything, any special.
Here we go. We toss up a
low level.
Z. I'm gonna put up a Z2 to try and get the blueprint. A quick exterminate before we go on to farming. Let's see how we go.
You're bringing Z2?
Yeah, I'm throwing up a Z2. Fully ratted, and that way it gives me a better chance.
I can't rat.
No worries, man. You don't have to put one up. I'm just putting it up as sort of.
But I have 9 of them, so.
Dude, don't show off. I only had 7.
I mean, you can have some of mine.
Dude, I can't take your relics. I'm happier farming for them, because then at least that way when we're farming for relics, we're kind of showing people what to do and how to do it.
That's a fact.
And it makes me look good.
I don't think anything can do that.
Voidfishers, you need to open a relic. But are you confident that you would stand?
Oh, there we go. Straight away into this. It's a beautiful man, just beautiful.
Use that reactant to don't forget the reactant. You need to open that relic.
And I can't even use any of my other abilities yet, man, until I get some levels on my Wukong. Now, just for reference, guys, it's probably never a good idea to go in a MLT survival like I were doing yesterday without at least some decent on your Wukong. As soon as you get your second ability, you're almost invincible, so it works quite nicely, but, you know, until then, you're just kind of fodder. At least the way I see it, I'm a fodder, man. I need to get up there. It's like you're throwing a snooker cue. It's first ability, it's basically, it's like, if you imagine how you hold a pool cue when you're about to take a shot, now do it one-handed while stood up and then push forward. That's basically his ability. Phase first, I don't want to do it here. There you go. I get 50 XP for doing the ability. But to be honest, I think that needs to be changed, that ability. It's kind of pointless. I mean, I don't know anyone that tries standing there to poke a fucking an enemy with a pool cue. I mean, it's like, ooh, you're so close. You're going to kill me. I'm going to hit you in the eye. Oh, shit. I missed. I got the wrong guy. You know what I mean?
It works in a bar fight every now and then.
Yeah, but... would you really want to take a Wukong to a bar? I mean, you take a Wukong to a bar, he's going to ask for a banana split. I mean...
Or a banana daiquiri.
Yeah.
Question is, do you really want a drunk monkey around the job?
It's great if you get locked out of your apartment building, just sent fucking monkey up the wall.
Yeah.
Right, I'm just gonna stand here and use up my energy. I'm just using up my energy for XP, guys. I know, it's spamming and it must be really annoying. You know, dude's so close to the exit and he's just standing there. That be, dude being me. Oh, baby! Baby, I got it first time round. Oh, baby.
Slow clap.
That is just sweet. Okay, so that's the mason. Now I just need the neuroptics and the thing.
That's because I was here. That's one of the reasons.
Yeah, it probably is. I mean, as soon as you've got the item, you're more likely to get it again.
I'm joking.
No, seriously. It's what I've noticed ever since I've been playing Warframe. If you need something, if you've got people in your team that already have it, then... and you pop the relic up, you're more likely going to get it.
Really?
Yeah. It's always been the case, I mean, that I've noticed. I mean, I don't know if it's a legitimate statement, but in my perspective, it is. Think about it. How many matches have we ever done with relic hunting where we're all looking for something and one person's actually got it?
Out.
Exactly. And he actually comes into games with us, and we tend to end up getting it fairly quickly. Now imagine, now think of all the games where we went in and nobody had it. That's when it comes down to random probability. But I think because others have it, it increases your probability of actually getting it, even though there's probably no, you know, scientific proven gaming basis for it.
You might be on a Sambra. You might be on a
Okay, so right, we need I need the Neuroptics and the chassis. And I'm gonna start the build on the system.
My Falcor is done.
Falcor's done.
Finally.
I don't even know. I can't think of what the Falcor is.
It's kind of like the glaive. It's like that newer glaive that came out. The disc.
Oh, the blue one.
Yep, yep.
Yeah, I got it, leveled it, not paid much attention to it since. Oh, Mag Prime Neuroptics, there you go. Mesa Prime Systems.
We could play Frisbee.
Okay, Mesa Prime Systems on the build. So I need the chassis and the Neuroptics, and then I'm good for that, and I just need to get the Redeemer. I quite like the Redeemer, but I think in its combat style, it could have more done to it. I mean, it's basically, and sorry guys, I'm not sure if you all know what a Redeemer is. So if you bear with me, I'm going to show you the standard version. Okay, it's a secondary weapon. No, and it comes under melee, which it's odd. It comes under melee because it's actually a shotgun. See what I mean? It's basically two blades with shotgun on it. You know what? I'm gonna edit the color on that because it needs to be. No, it's not that one. Strange. That one. There you go.
Yeah, I never built a Redeemer. I forgot I still need parts for it.
Yeah, you mean the really handy ones to build? Ooh, green. It looks a bit weird, but it'll work. Alright, so basically you've got two blades. Alright, and then you've got a sawn off shotgun in the middle and the blades are attached to it. So you swing it around as if you're going to chop someone up, and then you can blow them away. I mean, it's a really nice weapon, and it doesn't get as much TLC as it could do. I mean, I haven't even done as much with it as I want to. I haven't worked out what I'm going to do with it yet. But since I've got the Prime coming out, I'm just going to basically replace the standard Redeemer with the Prime version. So I need to get my hands on that soon as, really. And put my Authors Prime back up.
I need to build another dual scanner for my shit to be done, for my Redeemer to be able to.
Yeah.
I might as well get the Prime.
Well, if you haven't done the standard one, get that done first, because that's a whole 30 level XP that you could do with. And then once you've done that, then you're laughing because all you're doing then at that point is you're swapping it out for your Prime version. So, you know, that's all I ever do. I build a weapon, max it out until I'm happy with it. Ooh, the AK Jagara Prime. I haven't done that yet. I'll get sidetracked. Basically, you max it out as you want. I need to get the AK Vastor Prime Link.
Yo.
Sorry.
Have you ever seen this Cobra and Crane? I've never seen Cobra Crane. What is this?
What?
Cobra and Crane.
Cobra.
Look in your look in your melee weapons. This is new, bro. I've never seen this. Oh, it's Baruch's new weapon. It's Baruch's
Cobra weapon. And Crane. I know I've got the blueprint for a new melee, but as to what it is...
It's Baruch's. It's kind of like the Nami Scholar, two-handed, or like the shield. and a blade type shit. Kind of like that. It looks pretty dope. It looks pretty dope. I can buy the blueprint for 20,000. I'm gonna do that.
Hold on. That cross wall looks nice. Oh, castle wall. That looks quite pretty, actually. It's got spikes on it. Of course it looks pretty. But yeah, you mean a lot of this is like endo-based. Platinum-based. Right. Castle walls. Are you sure it's...
You don't have the castle wall?
No.
Yeah, the castle wall I've had for a long time. Yeah, get that. That shit is awesome.
It's 180 platinum.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know. I'm going to check out market.
How did I get mine?
Knowing you, probably a Verset. Primary melee weapons.
Yeah.
Castle War. Yeah, it's a platinum purchase. Unless it's in Dojo, which I don't think it actually is.
It might be, man. Check it out. I think that might be how I got it. I don't remember how I got it.
Okay, so let's look down here. What's the name of that weapon again?
Cobra and hold on. Where you want? Cobra and Crane.
Cobra and Crane.
I just bought the blueprint.
Are you sure it's not melee?
Yeah, it's melee.
Oh, Cobra and Crane.
Yeah.
For some reason, I was thinking Cobra and Cream. Fucking,
I'm not touching that.
Yeah, good job.
Did you say Cobra and Cream?
Yeah, shut up, man. Yeah. Stop picking on me. All right, I'm just going to jump into Clan Dojo at the moment and see if that weapon's there. Because if it is, I'll get it from there. If not, it's a purchase with plat. Which means I'm going to have to save up.
I've had that for shit a year or so now.
I'm sure you probably got it as part of a set, to be honest.
I don't know, because I haven't purchased a lot of sets.
Yeah, but it's not to mean that you haven't had a set purchase for you.
Not with that. Maybe. I don't know, man.
Let's see, Scourge.
Alp is the only one who ever bought me anything.
Quite true. That's what I mean. That's why you might have already got it.
I don't even know what he got me. I think he got me a skin or something.
Cross wall, research. Replicate.
Yeah, I knew that's where I got it from.
Hide everything. That's my last clan.
My first clan I got it from. Crappy clan.
It'd be nice if I could go through everything.
Give me a second, I'm about to turn this light on. Alright, so let's start getting some of this other magic shit. We're on the roll, we might as well keep rolling.
Yeah. I'm literally going to have to go through all the weaponry we've got in the Clan Dojo and see what I have and haven't got.
Alright, I'll come over.
I'm not going to do it now, I mean I'm streaming, so I'll do it sort of when I'm not streaming, and it'll take a bit of time.
Alright, we'll do it after the stream. We can do it after the stream. I mean, just go over it, take a look and shit.
Yeah.
I think I've got the majority of them, but some of them...
Do you know what would be cool is if they actually put in the Clan Dojo, besides the owned, put mastered. You know, so you know what you've mastered and what you haven't.
Yeah.
Well, I definitely haven't mastered it because there's no master sign, so that's on the build now. And it just cost me a former to build.
I wish they showed you what you own when you check relics. When you open relics and they show what different parts they come with, I wish they own.
Well, there's definitely some things. I mean, I need a Sindor Prime Blade for me, Sindor Battle Axe. I need two Glaive Prime Blades.
I need one. And I passed one up the other day for somebody.
So there's a lot of things that sort of need to be worked on, and then I might get my next master rank.
Same.
Okay. Let's see, man. Let's go to a meso capture. We'll toss in a random relic, and we'll see what pops out.
Yeah.
I mean, the meso systems I actually got from a run. Oh shit! Cancel. I forgot to invite Kuba. Oh man. Don't be like that, dude. You know what? I invite you. It's just fucking. My mind was like in a different place. It was thinking Mesa Prime.
Yeah, the problem is when you're in a different place, I'm not there. I'm not there.
It's not my fault, though, is it, really? Come on. Everybody knows me. I'm scatterbrained sometimes. So, you know. I start talking about one thing and I end up on something else.
I think that's all of us, especially when Bob Marley is involved with
it. So, yeah.
What are you bringing? What are you trying to open right now?
A random relic. I mean, I'm hoping that someone's going to toss up a Mesa relic in the mix in regards to, you know, a couple of randoms. So we're basically doing potluck.
But she has no Mesa relics. I get out of this one. She has no
Mesa relics. Has no Meso relics. Where? Okay, so we're looking at Neo, Axie, and Lith.
Lith.
Okay, lift, spy, lift, sabotage. No. Neo, exterminate. Last one, why not? And we'll throw in a relic with a bunch of prime systems on there. And Desra Prime and another one. Yeah, basically it's called random fishing. You pick a fisher, you just go in it, and you look to see what you randomly get. You know what I mean? You're not picking a specific relic to unlock, you're just randomizing. And that's all I ever really do. I just generally go for whatever's top of my list.
That's how I got her in the rockets. Not in the rockets, it's a chassis.
Yeah. Well, that's how I got the systems. But yeah, normally what I do is I just put my list to the number of relics you've got, and then I just tend to go in. That's it. I mean, not else.
You usually get good shit, man. You usually get good shit when you do the higher relic, like the Neo. You got a good chance to get shit. You need them to open a relic, but are you confident? Gotta get a lot of Neo in this. Defend yourself and use fusion, fusion breaking.
Oh sweet, I've now got my second ability. Invincible Wukong running round. That's it guys, when you get Wukong, your second ability is your be all end all. You know, it's what keeps you alive basically. The idea is as it were. Ooh. It works in this manner. It consumes your energy, even though it doesn't seem like it's doing anything. But as soon as your life force hits zero, it respawns you with 75% of your actual health. Now, it will keep repeating this process until you've got no health left. Now, a good tip is every one or twice it activates, and you'll know because it'll make a sound. Go and hide in a corner and then reactivate it, and then, for instance, say you die with a 900 health. You activate the ability activates. You die again. Your health goes down to 800. Same again. 700. Okay. So the amount of health you keep getting respawned with starts shrinking more and more, up to the point in which you get to 500. And then you think, do you know what? I need some more health, and I can't keep letting myself get killed too easily. So you go and hide in a corner, deactivate the ability, reactivate it, and then next time you die, you start up straight away with actually as if you've only died once. It respawns you the exact same health. You wankers! That was just mean! How could you, man? Do you know what? Everyone you've just been seen on stream has been mean. How could you do that to a bloke? Seriously. No, but the whole idea with... Oh, Reaper Prime. Reaper, it don't come round very often. Grab it. Forget the Helios, get the Reaper, man. Seriously, that Reaper, all right, everyone will eventually need it, and it's very rare that it comes down.
God, man, early. As soon as it came out, it's
nice. I can't do that, man. I've got to listen to my own voice. Dark's partner says, please shut the fuck up.
So sensitive.
Hey, do you know what? A bit of talking's fair enough, because at the end of the day, you know, you press your C on your keyboard, you have your chat, and then you let it go. In regards to some people, they have it open continuously, and it's like ridiculous. Like yesterday.
Really? You can have it open if you just leave it open?
Yeah. Someone had it open continuously yesterday. Right, get this. Me and Outcast were blasting around, literally sort of cracking some relics and whatever. Come into this game, while I'm streaming, come into this game, someone is blasting music down their actual microphone, right? Now, you would think it might be an error, it might be some sort of a mistake, you know, something not intended. Alright, okay, so the thing is, you take it onto that, you think, okay, it could be this. So you ask them to turn it off or sort of mute the microphone. And they turn around, well, you know what you can do, turn around and mute them. Alright, but the thing is, you would think if they weren't doing it to wind someone up, they would talk to the people that they're answering. So, for instance, say you're playing the music. I type in chat, can you turn the music off? You know, you would then turn around and you would say, no, because whatever. You can mute me. Yeah? You would actually say it. But this person took the time to type the message saying, no, but you know what you can do? You can mute me. Now, the thing is, they're blasting the music down the microphone, so why just fucking not talk? So, yeah,
so a lot of people are enjoying being dickheads.
Yeah, it proves it, though. It proves that that's the reason they were doing it. It's just annoying. I mean, it's like...
Is this a spy, yo? Did you put a spy on this?
Fuck no.
We're going to get food and shit.
Alright. It's something. I'm sure it's not a spy. I didn't do spy. Don't know. Another reference, guys, in regards to my Wukong, I've actually got it set so any damage I receive, 45% of the damage received gets converted into energy, which then powers my second ability. So it's a nice little cycle. You can increase that by using the two energy mods. Hunter Adrenaline is the one that gives you 45% energy for any damage you receive. And then whatever energy is used, 120% of it is actually... any energy used on abilities, 120% is then converted into overshields. Now, the other mod is called Rage, and it tended to be one of the most common mods that everyone used, even when Hunter Adrenaline first came out. Now, the difference is it doesn't have a secondary effect, and it uses, it only provides 40% energy. Do you know what? I think this has actually turned out to be a fucking spy.
Yeah, man, these are rocks, man. This is bullshit. I'm in the least stealthy fucking frame.
Dude, I'm running around with fucking Wukong.
Well, you got smoke. You can go onto your little smoke cloud shit.
And this is what I meant by smoke. However, it doesn't prevent you from setting the alarms off using smoke.
I think there is a...
On the upside, you know... Yeah, there is a mod. That's for Evara, though.
I think it's one for Wukong. It's called something.
On the upside, you know, you can move fairly quickly. It just consumes your energy. I'm a ghost. I'm floating in midair.
Woo! It come ghost show ass over here and get this brought out of here. Oh, he's got me. Didn't got me.
No,
Who's getting C? Are you getting C?
I'm on my way to it. It's generally who gets there first, I expect.
I'm gonna go slow. Sure, I'm gonna do that.
Dude, you went wrong way.
Shut up. You don't have to tell the chat, right? You've been
seen. Yeah, the smoke effect for Wukong is quite handy because it stuns the enemies. There you go. Always use your cipher keys, guys, until you've got the better experience of being able to actually hack. Or just say, once you've got the experience to hack, it's better off if you use your cipher keys so you can speed stuff up. You can't...
Always be building.
I don't need to. I've got like 800 and odd of them at the moment.
They're like over 300 something. I've been using them. You use them all the time. Still.
Yeah.
Always build. Always.
Well, what I tend to do is whenever I've got the supplies, I just sort of build armor, shield, plates, energy plates, health plates. I don't really focus on the... Oh, my Wukong leveled up nicely. I don't actually focus on certain aspects like the ammo plates because I actually want to get I want to get a large ammo plate and I'm only using mediums at the moment, so basically it makes less than the most efficient method. However, I've got to change a syndicate to do that. Ballistica Paris Prime Former. The former's the only one I don't have at least four in.
Yeah, I was collecting them last night. Barrel Kateri's here too, so
yeah.
Come on.
Well, there's no I want offer him. There is, and I've got the ducats to do it, I just don't have the credits. And he'll be gone later anyway, so I'm not that bothered. And everything he's got will come round again eventually. Might take a year or so, literally, but, you know, it will eventually come back aground.
I will be trying to get this shit that he has, at least the two weapons.
Yeah, it's a crossfire that I put up.
Alright, crossfire for Neos, I guess.
So, how is everyone in the streams today? You've been having a good day? You've been enjoying yourself? Am I your first streamer you've seen today, or have you seen some others? Let me know, I'd like to say hello. And if you just want to lurk, that's fine as well. But you know, if you do sort of say hi, then at least I know that people want to watch. Kind of helps us streamers' confidence out, you know. All I wanna do is have some fun. Now I want a cheeseburger and then go on another. I don't know. The wife looks like she's concentrating so hard her head's gonna explode. What you doing, babes? Oh, loser's on.
Tenno, you are here to infiltrate the vaults and retrieve highly sensitive enemy information. They'll have plenty of robotics. Corpus never fight for themselves.
Is this the same shit, bro?
Droid fishers, you need them to open a relic, but are you confident you can withstand their... Defend yourself and use reactive...
Oh, man. Is it just me, or is news just seem to be getting nastier and nastier? I mean, if it's not people being abducted, it's people being killed and murdered and then fucking, you know, right? In the news, in the past couple of days, I've had some really horrible things appear in news. For instance, there's been a man and a woman arrested for a fire in the house and the death of four of the kids. Yeah, another one killing a toddler. Fucking, and now there's one for an abduction. Yeah, someone's been arrested for abduction and he's from Poland. Oh, I should say his mum's in Poland. I'm not sure if it says he's in Poland. There's a statue, dude. If you haven't seen it.
I got it. Yeah, I don't watch the news, but I do.
Yeah. I mean, to be honest, I generally don't watch the news. I try not to, because they're all nasty stuff. But you never know what's going on in the world if you don't open your eyes on occasion.
Not watching the news don't mean that you don't have to get...
Oh, it does for me, because it's the only time I actually pay attention.
There's other sources of getting current events.
Alright, get this, yeah? Imagine you got sent back in time, or you was put in a position where you was you were sent forward in time, and they wanted to know where it is that you actually came from. Do you know what year? All right, and you can't remember any dates of anything. Yeah. So they turn around and say to you, right, what was happening in the world at the time? You don't know. She weren't paying no attention.
Yeah, of course. I'm not saying don't pay attention. I'm saying don't watch fucking broadcast news. Other sources to get your news from, other than that trash.
But fucking, I mean, I start thinking about it in that method, and it's like, well, the closest thing I could say right now would be the Brit X. That's it. But if it don't make it into history books, how would you ever know?
My homepage is set up to give me the current. I get a news thread every day on my phone, and it tells
me. You're just lurking. Hey DJ, how you going?
That's what I do. So now watching that fucking news. I hate it.
Well, I'll tell you what, the only news I really enjoy watching is called anime. Because anything that happens in there isn't actually real. So I've got no problems of it being gory or whatever. It's just when it comes to a possibility of being real, I just can't stomach it. I'm not doing too bad, thank you. I am cross-platform streaming at the moment. So, sort of spreading my name out there a little bit more. I've got it on YouTube, Twitch, and Mixer, all at the same time. I don't know how the YouTube one's going, because Well, for a start, I don't know how to get onto the YouTube streamers thing. But it's a bit funny that, really, isn't it? I watched a YouTube video. I had to set up a YouTube stream link. So I did that. So now I'm streaming on YouTube, Mixer, and Twitch in the hopes that, you know, the streams will become more fun and people will come and chat. However, the only two I can actually access, as in I actually know what to do in regards to accessing the stream information to watch streamers, is actually Twitch and Mixer, which is sort of simple and easy. I'm fucking lost. Where am I? Oh, I'm going downstairs, aren't I? I need to go out top. But yeah, I'm basically sort of one step forward. And we'll see how we go. Ooh, Nakama Skyblade, it's a gold. I don't need the others, so we're good.
I got the Prime boot. I'm not interested. Is there any reason why I need Kagaki
Prime? Say that again, dude.
Is there any reason I need Kagaki Prime? Do you use it? I don't think anybody uses Kagaki
Prime. To be honest, it's a good slide weapon. I mean, because it's basically two blades on each arm. Oh, a blade on each arm.
Kagaki?
Yeah.
Thought it was a punching ship, a fish ship.
No, that's Kanoga or something like that.
What are we going for?
Another Neo Crossfire. We will get round to farming the Mesa relics, but I want to crack some while we're here. And it just helps, you know, you need ducats and shit, so it kind of helps out a bit. Right. Me, I'm all good. It just increases my stockpile, and hopefully I'll get some more formers.
That's why I'm breaking the trash joint, and I'm not breaking nothing.
Yeah.
Any specific
Fair stuff. Enough.
Also, I have
a fish trap. So, in stream wise, how is everyone anyway? What you all been up to today? Yeah, has it been a warm day where you are, or has it just been fucking miserable, or just cold? I mean, up here we've had a bit of rain over the past few days, and just before that we had a bit of snow. But I have seen sort of on. Weather reports for US, there was like minus 30 of a week.
Went from warm to freezing cold.
Yeah. Oddly enough, though, I think the UK would be more accommodated to suit that minus 30 than the US, just because you guys over there tend to get a lot of heat, don't you? So a drop that bad could be really bad.
The northeast is pretty cold. Well, the north everywhere is. Even North California.
Yeah,
we'll regularly get something.
I'm basically robbing everything.
Once or twice during the winter, we usually get some below zero shit. And some oddly warm days. It was like 65 degrees the other day.
Yeah.
It's just weird.
Generally, room temperature is about 35 Celsius, I can handle. You know, lower I can handle, but when it gets above that, that's when I start sort of gasping for air. I couldn't handle heat in America, that's why I'll never go there on holiday.
It gets pretty cold in the east and the north, it gets pretty cold.
And there's one other reason I won't be able to walk home. You know, I'm one of those people, if something happens, I want to be able to at least be able to walk home. Even if it takes me a couple of days to do it, I still want to be able to walk home. But, you know what I mean, if I were holidaying in another country, it's like, not going to be possible.
Right.
I mean, it's like, fucking, yeah, let's walk home, straight through the ocean. Couple of hundred, a couple of miles down, I mean, pressure alone would kill me, let alone trying to breathe.
Drink some wine, eat some fish, and do the Jesus walk over the water.
Alarms. Data destruction is imminent. Need to hurry. Data integrity verified. Retrieval was successful.
I mean, normally I'd be using me Vara on this, but I'm really needing to level up me with Wukong.
She's printing the song.
Yeah, I must admit, this is quite a...
This is what a spy mission.
Let's fly. Huh. Sounds a bit like a storm. You coming upstairs, Kuba?
Yeah, I was just looting shit.
Alright, cool. We've got a question. What is your favorite American food?
American food?
Yeah.
I guess like the Thanksgiving, Christmas shit with turkey and mashed potatoes, veggies and shit, mac and cheese. You know, Thanksgiving food.
Okay. No, me thinking it might be a hot dog. Get to extraction. I suppose that's probably profiling, because over in the UK, it's like the American foot-long hot dog seems to be like the biggest, you know, food over there that everyone seems to like. That and grits. I'm not sure what grits are, but you know.
Yeah, I haven't had grits in more than 10 years or so. Yeah, the information is quite
what?
You know where the source is.
Well, it's like, if you look at Yorkshire people, we tend to like his Yorkshire puddings quite a lot. I mean, another one's called Toad in the Hole, where it's a big Yorkshire pudding with bangers. You know, sausages, onions, gravy, you know, all in the same pot.
Yeah, oh, it's all in the hole. Gravy. Well, in New York, a lot of Chinese takeout is probably more than most things.
A lot of Chinese takeout. Have you ever tried wasabi?
Yeah.
What do you think of it?
Sushi a lot. If you mix it with soy sauce correctly, if you don't put too much wasabi with the soy sauce, it's delicious.
All right, question. Have you ever done the wasabi fuck-up?
So, what's that exactly?
Where you get a big chunk of wasabi thinking it's something else and you eat it. That's called the big wasabi fuck-up, man. Seriously, that's an obvious one.
Wasabi
fuck-up. Oh, we got...
Yeah, I did that as a
We got the Avara piece. It's quite funny, that. Okay,
I did the horseradish fuck up. I didn't know what horseradish was when I was a kid, and I ate a mouthful of that shit and almost fucking died. That shit fucking killed me, dude. I felt that shit for days.
Yeah, it's not so good when it comes out the other end either.
Yeah.
Not as bad as jalapenos, though. They just fucking ring sting.
Yeah, ring sting is right, brother.
Yeah,
I love them though.
Oh, we got Zenoric. Okay, I'm just gonna.
Mexican is probably though. I probably eat more South American style food more than anything. I don't eat beef or pork. I eat chicken and fish. So played a lot of kind of popular.
Yeah. More than that. I must admit, it's fucking. There's a lot of foods out there I'd love to try, and others that I like the look of, I like the idea of, but there's not a chance in hell that I would. I mean, it's like ghost chilies.
I want to know who the fuck we eat grits and hot dogs.
Yeah, do you know? Do you know what grits like and shit like that?
The main food in America is grits.
And hot dogs. Yeah, man, seriously, grits and that. I'd love to try them, and the American. You know, big massive hot dogs, you know, a proper stadium though, proper baseball stadium or something. God. Yeah,
That's not even the main thing in the stadium anymore. It's more like nachos and chicken things.
Yeah, I know, but to be honest, I like meat more than I like fucking cardboard, and nachos tend to be cardboard.
Yeah, that's definitely right. But I must admit, there is a hot dog that you should try if you do go on holiday or come on holiday to New York or whatever. You got to try Nathan's hot dogs. Nathan's hot dogs, their chips are amazing.
Yeah. Well, it's pity you couldn't send me some over, dude.
Amazing. It might not be that great once it gets over there.
Do you want to queue up a relic gathering for the Mesa system and chassis? Neuroptics and chassis. I'll leave it to your expertise.
Gonna go to Mott, man. I'm just gonna go to MOT.
That's fine by me.
Because you're gonna need that H4 and it's hard to come by.
I've got one H4.
You
do? Yeah.
That is awesome. You have an Axie H4.
Yeah, I got the H4.
That's excellent because it takes a long time to get it.
I forgot what part that gives you, though. I've got the systems, I got the blueprint, I need the chassis and the neurooptics.
I think the H4
is a to distract the enemy while a fellow Tenno operative raids the ship for much needed supplies.
Just for reference, if anybody in any of the streams would like to join us on Warframe, we are on the PC and I am using a 360 controller, so it is gamer controller enabled if you like that kind of thing. But yeah, if you want to join us, just send us a message posting your in-game name and I'll send you an invite. Other than that, you can do /join space Winter4UK. But not right now because we're now full. Oh, yeah. And
hey.
Yo, Wings. How you doing, man?
Pretty good, yeah.
Not bad. There we go.
If you find a room, lock it down.
Yeah, not a problem.
Somebody's dead.
We got an Oberon.
Nice.
Oberon, use your ability 2 and 3 combo, and you should be good if you've got a good build. If not, let me know, and I can always sort you out and info on a good build. Do you know what's funny? I always, when I say stuff like that, I automatically assume they know who I am. It could be any person in chat that's saying it.
Like, fuck you, I've been playing for 40 years.
Well, you mean, to me, it would be a thought that they don't have a good build. And I'd say that just because, you know, they were downed already. I mean, my Oberon build's based on energy consumption and gain. The more damage they do to me, the more energy I get. The only time it don't work too well is when they're so high, they're one shot killing me. And that's what.
Yeah, I know if you had. You already would have been like, you're like, Father, get over here, computer.
Yeah, I'm.
And stand here. He's using his.
Yeah. Well, I've already done my setup, so that it sort of helps with the survivability. I mean, my Oberon's got a buff on it that allows him to, I think it's called Phoenix Renewal, the mod. If I'm gonna die, it'll respawn with me full health, so I don't actually die. And then it has to wait 90 seconds for it to be activated again. However, the same Oberon has got a Dijin on there, which does self-sacrifice as well. So if you actually do go down and it survives, it'll sacrifice itself up to 3 times to get you up. But then it destroys itself completely, which isn't so bad. Hold on. There we go. Found a room. Camp room, everyone. I'm just going to stand in the doorway and let him come to me. I need XP, so I'm good anyway. I'm so good, I'm attacking the bullets. Okay, that Oberon's build is gone mostly for range by the look of it. I mean, if you want a survivable build, you don't actually need a lot of range. Yeah, they definitely went for a high range build. Okay, so my Dijins just kept me alive. Nice little room, 4 doorways, we're all good. Oh. That way.
Additional life support has arrived.
Yeah, mods and that in there, dude, if you've got a waypoint.
Critical life support levels. Extraction.
Just put a whole bunch of them in there.
Life support on the way.
Tug a life support if you can, man.
Oh.
They all managed to get us a second. Sweet.
That should keep you going. There we go.
Power throw for anyone that wants it.
Incoming.
That's me resetting my ability. War's coming to say hi. Dropped a waypoint.
I've delivered another life support capsule.
I reckon cells at waypoint. That one learnt to fly. Oh, toxic barrage.
Look what our Tenno operative just found. They could not do this with
just picked up toxic barrage near waypoint one.
Tenno, prepare for life support.
I'm going to tag some life support.
Another life capsule is now available. Life support has been replenished.
I must admit, I do like Wukong's iron staff. Reason for is it sounds like a lightsaber.
Yeah, it kind of does.
Yeah. Wukong is your father. That'd have been funny as fucking actual Star Wars if Wukong turned out to be Darth Vader.
Yeah.
Didn't mean to drop that. I've got them set on my D-pad for the energy shields and whatever. No, why not? Cancel that off. Just take advantage of it for now. Perfect camp spot. We get at least three towers in this same look space.
Life support activated. Additional life support has arrived.
I'm coming. Alright, dude. Chat with you later.
Alright, mm-hmm.
Okay.
Thank you. Thanks for joining us, man.
Mm-hmm.
Life support on the way. We will all share in this bounty. Hold out as long as you can. Another life support capsule.
Let's see what we can get on the seat.
Man, I'm getting some great perk defenses. That arbitration mod is actually quite useful. Yeah. Fuck yeah, look at side of that bugger. Well, what it basically does is when it's maxed out, it gives you a resistance to anything you hit with. So any ability or any proc that hits you, you get a resistance to it for so long. And it stacks up to 90%. But the thing is, it's not just one. I mean, at the moment, I've got a resistance to 1, 2, 3, 4 different things. It all depends on what the enemy hits you with, but yeah, you basically get a resistance to anything you get hit with. No limit to what. Yeah, impact, explosion, slash, elementals, it all counts. Your resistance for each one lasts for 20 seconds, but it's like it's only 10%, however, that stacks up to 90%, so if you get hit with the same thing over and over again, you end up getting 90% resistance for as long as you've got it going. Oh, nice. Sculpture. I'm not too sure, actually.
That should keep you going for a while.
Okay, I'm going for the sculpture. Watch Senkuba on your left.
Life support incoming.
Statues everywhere. All of them for me. Yeah. I'm gonna beat you up, you little corpus. Kick your teeth in because It's funny.
There's a lot of range on that shit.
What has a lot of range?
He's overrun now.
I mean, it has a ton of range. I think that's what they've basically gone for. Downside, we've been mostly for range. It will be energy consumption ridiculous when it comes to health regeneration. It's not regenerating enough health. I mean, I when my perks line up, I've got like 661 on shields and 126 on the health regeneration per second. I mean, and I can handle a lot of health regeneration for everyone. My only downside is my own durability. But this arbitration mod could be actually quite useful in that manner. So you... Yeah. I mean, it's really hard because it's like, I don't want to seem to be like a one mod wonder. But when you find a mod that really can do a lot of work and benefit all your frames in certain ways, it's... You know... Yeah. I mean, growing power, arbitration, these are two mods that I'm actually coming to like quite a lot. I mean, on the upside, the massive range is allowing the enemies to start attacking each other because of radiation proc. So it does lessen what we have to deal with. So it has got its benefit, it's just, too much range and we can't get them to stack up close enough to actually make the most out of getting the drops for the air filtration. I'm a coming. Critical life support levels. Extraction is your best. I got it. Life support activated. And if we need it, there's a third one in the same room, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's why it's one of the best rooms for camping.
Yeah.
Ooh, Iron Staff level 29, baby. So it's getting there. My Wukong is level 30. It's a bit of a letdown. True. But these are MOT, I mean, higher levels, I'd expect to get a bit more XP from them. Nice bit of range on me, Ignis. Come on, bye bye. Okay. Life support's clocking at 30 at the moment.
Bounty. Hold out as long as you can. Trying to get over the next sea
location. Hmm. Me, I'm just killing him. I wasn't thinking about rotation.
I'm saying we are 25 right now. That's why we rotate.
Oh shit.
I've delivered another life support capsule.
Which I was asking you how long you could go.
Me, I'll stay as long as everyone else wants to. It's a good place for grabbing relics, and I'm getting XP, so I'm happy either way. I just got there for you. And you just respawn yourself.
Shoot, who's having an ass off this? Let me down.
So what, dude?
I said it was a quick reaction, I just wanted to get up and
Yeah. Shoot
his ass off.
Thank you. I'm coming.
I'm not gonna hide back up.
Am I right? Oh, you're up there.
Also on the dev stream, they pointed out that they made new animations when you damage enemies. When you shoot them in the head, make new animations for the on the head, the arm, the face, the react. That's good. That's good.
Thanks for the pickup, dude.
Life support incoming.
To be honest, I can't always hear over gunshots, dude.
I say I'm not always paying enough attention to my eyes, man.
Yeah.
Get ready for a capsule.
Stood away from the mic a little bit.
Yeah, don't forget, you activate it when you get your get your first proc for that extra strength. I'm assuming you've got growing power on there, aren't you?
Not on this one.
I've delivered another life support capsule.
This is my A-level.
I need to help that some of us. I so love these piranhas. We're doing nice. It's not bad doing a good survival for a stream.
A lot going on. A lot of information I can give him. As long as the crew is good.
Yeah. Oh, we need nice someone to talk in chat, and we're sort of there.
Oh, they also show on. Keep giving you updates for the devil's hand because you didn't see it. So it's just annoying. So they showed a actual model of the railjack ship.
Yeah. Sweet.
It's gonna be in the dojo. Dojo is where the garage board is.
Did they give a date for it though?
No definite date. I'm expecting rapid. Just to make Tenogen a bigger group line. Tenokan, pardon me.
I'd love to go to something like that.
Tenokan?
Yeah. To be honest, I think the only time I would ever end up going to stuff like that, just because the way I'm at the moment, is sort of someone booking everything and fucking a car picking me up and taking me there and then bringing me back.
I mean, if I'm gonna go to a convention, what's it like, a car? Real damn shit. I would go actually and like, take a lap around the shit, just to check it out and see what's up.
I'd go for goodies. Whenever you go, they always give you the latest information on stuff that they haven't released elsewhere. Plus you tend to get sort of keys and things to access for certain stuff that you can't normally get your hands on.
Yep. So yeah, that's what I mean. I'll do a little lap and get the goodies, get my little swag bags or whatever. As for going to, what do they have, like the costume contest and all of that shit, and all the panel discussions, I'll go to. I would check it out, definitely. They did it here, like in New York, like a graduate conference or like that?
Yeah, basically. I mean, I've never actually been to one myself, so I assume it'd be the same.
I've never been to, actually, I've never been to any video game thing convention, but I've been to a lot of electronic conventions. They have one called CES Show in Vegas every year. Pretty huge. Went to that. Nothing like just strictly video game related. Yeah, miss a couple of.
There you go, some extra shields.
Look what our Tenno operative just found. They could not do this without you. Additional life support has arrived.
That's
his
level.
Life support has been replenished.
That's the levels are doing better than my Arthur Flag.
Fuck, man. What I've noticed, best thing for piranhas, headshots. As much multi-shot as possible. Headshot with radiation damage, so even if you don't kill them, they'll turn around and start killing each other.
Melts right through the ass. Instead of just.
Life support activated.
Well, actually, I think my build might have changed. Since I'm using this rhythm.
Another life support capsule.
I'm more leaning towards it. I think it's pretty beefy. Losing lots of bonus for the bad move. Doesn't quite feel like it. Good run. Okay.
I'm good. Okay, I'm dead.
Additional life support has arrived.
Why not?
Thank you.
Whew, we're getting there.
That should keep you going for a while.
Ooh. Not too sure why, but they got me. Maybe I run out of energy.
The longer you fight, the more successful we will be.
Yeah, Crowshift's alright for low levels, but I don't think it really helps much on higher levels. I mean, these are in 90s, I'm using Crowshift on my Igneous, and it basically it's burning them and it's removing their armor, but even so, it's still taking its time, you know what I mean? I have to find something to increase my fire rate, I expect.
Even scaled up quite a bit.
That is quite true.
Support on the way.
Looks like it's for spinning attacks now.
Additional life support has arrived. We will all share in this bounty. Hold out as long as you can.
Man, I'm finding it hard just to slice through one. Do you know what's funny? You look at these and you compare them to levels in Simulacrum and fucking, you know, even in Simulacrum they just don't seem to hit this hard. I should say you could slice through them a lot easier in Simulacrum.
Yeah, I think it's more to do with the scaling, you know. They're like
attitude.
Mm. More and more aggressive. This is how we put now.
I literally stood behind you so you could still shoot and saw someone else decide to stand in front of you. Man, Wukong's finally level 19. I got a health increase. 19.
What? After all this time?
Yeah, man.
How many form on him so far?
Four, maybe? No, it ain't. It's hitting this post here. Man, these fucking fingers are Phoenix Rune all activated, my Djinn died for me. So it's all down to my abilities now until one of them comes back. Hold on, gotta.
Another life support capsule is now available. You are running out of time. Consider extraction.
My ass has got ass.
Oh shit.
91k XP to revive. And fucking thing. I would, but now I've got 90-odd KXP to get back. I'm too stubborn to go on a negative. I'll let you grab.
I've delivered another life support
capsule. Everyone dies.
Life support has been replenished.
Thank you.
Life support activated.
Life
support activated.
I so love the smoke.
Let's get the fuck out of here.
Come on, respawn. No wonder we were getting targeted from a bow. A drone had got stuck at wall.
Get
Yo, wait 20 odd more seconds so we can get his time up. Can't believe they were gonna bail.
Life support incoming. We will all share in this battle. Hold out as long as you can. You are running out of time. Consider extraction. Life support has replenished.
And the smoke is coming.
Shit. You're making your way over there, right?
Dude, I'm here, man. Additional life support has arrived. Oh, man. Thanks for the game, guys. I was streaming the whole thing.
That was a nice little rumble.
Yeah, and if I didn't die twice...
Crazy at the end.
Yeah, if I didn't die twice, I'd have probably got level 30 straight up, Wukong, instead.
Turned up on us. They turned up on us at the end, man. They turned up.
Yeah, you think... Fucking, they kicked the crap out of us, man.
It's pretty, it doesn't, I mean, it's not really like a graduating scale when they turn up. It's kind of like a light switch, like around there, be like...
Yeah, it's like... Kind of knocking them down. It's like level 40, level 50, level 60, so level 100.
That's your ass.
I mean, they just chow down on it.
Yeah, man.
That was a straight up nice game, that.
Alright, so where we at right now, what you have and what
I need four levels for Wukong. I got my iron staff maxed. Oh, relic wise, fucking fuck knows, man.
I mean, might as well be killing three, four birds.
Let's see. Gotta get rid of corrosive. So, and replace it with viral. So, it's rid of the electricity and back in the cold, I think.
I want rage. And
brain. Toxin.
I will bring Ash out, man. Ash out. Needs. Yeah, he needs form.
Vicious frost impact.
Sweet mama. Pretty good.
And put some rendering strike on the extra slashers.
Yo, you know what we need to do, man.
Yeah.
That has not been done in a long time.
What?
We need some arcanes, man.
Fuck yeah, we haven't done that in a while. Do you know what gets me about Warframe at the moment? How many people do you know that do spin attacks which come off of a wall or all like that? I mean, they've got a leap attack, so when you jump at them and attack them with a melee, that's great. When you do a spin attack, that's fine. But a wall attack, do you ever do a wall attack?
Never. Yeah. Sometimes. But it's very rare. Very rare.
I mean, they fucking... I've got like 4K on a wall attack.
Yeah, yeah. I know
And I'm barely just scratching 1,700 on a bloody standard melee.
You would think with Maimed Strike.
Yeah.
You know, you wouldn't need them to go so deep. But it's been like that forever.
Maximum speed.
They go apeshit with the spinning attacks and wall attacks.
Okay, well, my iron staff is, I got three former on it. But I think I might have to put another one on it. Because underneath the Primal Fury, the actual stance for it, there's like three little pinholes, you know, in regards to where you're leveling it up. And I think that's done by former. But if it is, I'm not sure why the third one's not lit, because it's already level 30. Well, let's have a look. Definitely need to improve on this. Combo duration.
Romanese.
Let's see, so we've got Berserk for extra speed. Then we've got Maiming Strike for crit chance. Spoiled Strike for damage. We've got Prime Pressure Point for melee damage. Prime Reach for extra range. Blood Rush for crit chance again. We've got Electricity for shock the fuckers. Stasis is basically a fucking ability. Get rid of that.
Yo, in a minute, I'm gonna take a short break. I have to go get some food and.
Yeah, not a problem. I'm looking at a way of. Critical damage. 10% crit chance.
This is your Wukong, you still tweaking?
Yeah, I'm actually tweaking the Orthros Prime at the moment. Sort of get the most out of it. Impact damage. It's a slash. It's a chance. Oh, I don't know. Attack speed minus slash vulture. Why not? Slice them up a bit more. I don't know what I should do to improve on it, to be honest. I need to get the most out of it, and most DPA. Or DPS, should I say.
There's just so much shit to do on Warframe, man. Build me to back to Fortuna. Got leveling to do on Fortuna like crazy. There's a need to get Garuda. Garuda's still waiting for gems and shit. Gotta get that shit. Especially now that I got my mezzo. Get the frames finished. Okay, I'm checking on my Wukong. I have 2 former.
Yeah, I'm on a 4 former at the moment. I'm thinking I can.
Not a bad build. Leaning more towards strength and duration.
Yeah.
It's an average build. It's not
perfect.
You primed. It'll charge
strength
for the
war. Minus efficiency. I need efficiency in the wrong range. Okay. Strength minus efficiency. No, I just lose out. Secret and a power drift. That could work. Get rid of that. Okay. Where do I put it? I'm thinking energy conversion. It gives you 50% extra strength on your next cast. So when you're making, say, doing your staff, do you know what? I'll just make that as a pure strength build when I do that. It will be marked on navigation. 1 second. So. Energy conversion. Conversion. I'm making a Wukong that's stupid. OP stupid.
What's the stats on your iron staff?
My actual iron staff. 1,700 viral, 697 impact, 221 puncture, attack speed of, give me a second, 1, let's see, crit chance 40%, that's basically it.
I've 1,153 impact, 630 sure.
Yeah.
2,034 radiation.
Shit, man. What's your attack speed?
1.6.
0.6. That's slow.
1.6. 1.6.
All right, 1 or 0?
1.
All right, 1. So it's 1.6. That's fast.
Yeah, 1.6.
Huh. How? What you got on it?
My build is Primal Fury.
Yeah.
Right? That's for the Iron Staff. I think that.
Yeah, you can't remove that or anything, so.
Okay. All right, so Prime Pressure Point,
yep.
Sundering Strike, Fury.
Rendering Strike.
Gladiator Vice, that's what ups my attack speed. Gladiator Vice. Auger Strike. Shocking Touch. Molten Impact. And Reach.
Mm. Take a screenshot and post it, mate. I think that'd be sort of nice to share.
I have a problem with my screenshots. I've been trying to hunt them down. I can't find them.
What are you? Are you on about using what screenshot do you use?
Just regular Windows screenshot, I guess.
Yeah.
It might have had something to do with Steam.
Hmm.
I had it going through Steam before, so. What a key strike, what a key command, take a screenshot. What do you use to take a screenshot?
I use Lightshot. Yeah, it's basically just called Lightshot. It'll either upload it straight to the website or not. Bear with me a second, guys. I'm actually taking a look at what my stats will be for the Authors Prime in combat, because I'm thinking it's definitely going to be something that's going to be more than what I'm thinking. It's more than what it's saying stat wise, so we'll see. So bear with me a second. Alright, so we've got Prime Pressure Point. Where's the? Okay. That's a B. Okay, Prime Pressure Point. Oh. So reach. Where else? Fever strike. Hold on. So minus that. Okay, rendering strike, we are minus. Okay. Won't be second, everyone. What I'm going to do is, once I have done this, I'm going to post the actual stats. Let's see. Berserker. Let's see. Alright, what's next? Gladiator might. Frost. Vicious Frost. Final mod is True Steel. There we go. Alright. Berserk buff. Ah, so the Berserk buff. Okay, so we'll add on the channeling. Critical chance. Interesting. Combo counter. We'll set 2 times. Maximum. Yeah, according to this build suggestion, I don't know, just looks like the damage isn't going to be enough.
Build suggestion for what?
Do you know my actual build for my Authors Prime? Well, what I've done is I've gone on to a builder so I can put in the mods and get an idea of what it is that's going to work and what isn't. Okay, now the thing is, it's not working as well as I hoped it would, so it's kind of a bit of a pain in the ass.
I don't even use the Orphos phone.
Alright. Okay, guys, I'm going to post a link in the chat. There you go. And that is sort of, if you copy and paste, that will sort of give you a screenshot of the actual stats of the build. If they were all active, I'm sending you same thing, Kuba, through Discord. Looking at this, if everything was maxed and the combo count was set halfway, I'd be looking at a sustained damage per second 5,560 on the melee. However, you have got a problem, because when you are actually calculating this, this is including channeling, which gives you a plus 50,000% fucking damage, whatever. But your main problem is fucking enemies, you know what I mean? It's hard to get that count up if your enemies aren't coming quick enough. So I definitely need to look at improving on my build setup for that. I'm just not really sure how to right now. Okay, now I'm going to switch over to viral on that, so I get heat and viral for that damage. Let's see. Okay, now in this, when I actually do level up my Igneous, I have got a few options available to me, but to be honest, if I do it, I'd have to focus sort of on one build and go with it. But for now, it'll do. Let's see, appearance. Gonna get rid of that black. And we'll do it as a mild pinkish colour. Just because we don't, and a greyish colour for the smoke. Just basically because we don't want black, makes it hard to see through. Okay. Ready when you are, dude. What's next? Actually, we'll take a look at last mission results. So we've got an Axie L2, Neo S5, Axie L3, A2, G1, R2, S9, N8, M2, some goodies. I mean, my Author's Prime build is not really the best. Even I'm sort of missing something out of it to make the most out of it. But I mean, what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to get a weapon that is basically a fucking monster without it taking ages to deploy and use. I mean, when it comes to weaponry, melee weapon, my Author's Prime is nowhere my strongest. You know, Paracesis is. And with that fucker, you know what I mean, it's a monster. Just the shockwave of it hitting the floor could send enemies flying. So I've done an hour solo using the just that. Works great. Author's Prime is more about slashers and criticals. Even though it's, you know, not really 100% for crits. So this is why I've modded it to go on maximum crit. Or mostly crit.
Alright, so what are we get? What are we on? Still doing mesoforming?
Yep. Okay, extra damage and lower the attack speed, or extra crit.
So to switch it up, you already got an H4. So you got it.
I do, yes.
Alright, so you don't have the lift, right?
Lift what?
I think it's M3. Hold on, let me make sure. Yes, lift and free.
Lift and free.
M3, like mama.
Oh, I'd actually be daddy, not your mama. M3. No, I don't.
Sad you won't be my mama.
Dude, I ground you to take your computer off you and play on it myself.
I know you would. You probably would beat me. You probably would definitely.
I'm not that kind of guy, dude. I'm as soft as they come.
Well, that's the kind of guy you are, but that doesn't have. It's nothing to do with kind of mom.
Totally. Ooh, a Harrow Suffragan. It's an helmet. I don't know if I've got it.
Harrow what?
An Harrow helmet on alerts. It's a defense. Right. It breaks it up a bit.
You were supposed to help me get my other Harrow.
Help you get your what?
You never did it. My other piece for Harrow. You know I still don't have a Harrow.
Shit, man, I thought you'd done that yonks ago.
Yeah, man.
Oh, bloody hell, dude. You take your time, yeah. Don't you? This
You know, kind of get caught up with one frame and put a lot into it for long periods of time. All the excuses I can throw at you that you'll believe right now. But yeah, shamefully, I still don't have an Atlas, but I never built Atlas.
Dude, I'm one of those people. You turn around and say, "Oh, I need help. I'll help you." But if you turn around and forget yourself, what am I supposed to do? Ooh.
I'm trying my best to argue with you, brother. Alright, I brought Ash. Just know that. You have to pick my. Wrong time. You're rusted.
Is it me, or is the fighting style at the moment seem to be getting crappier and crappier?
With Ash?
No, I mean, the stances, they don't seem to be doing shit.
I don't think that's just you, bro. That might be a general consensus, bro. Because I don't see him doing shit. And who knows what they're doing for us, preparing for us.
I mean, my attack speed's pretty fast. Which is fine on the build I've got. It's just, you know. Oh, I don't know.
I'm trying to remember why I love Ash, bro. Takes a minute, but once you get it, bro, he's pretty slick. Fourth is a lot.
It takes me 4 strikes with my orphans to kill these, and they're not even that high level.
More strikes with you, what?
With me, Orthos.
Oh, yeah? I brought along the, Valcor to level it up, see how it works. So far. Doing this.
Do you know what it could be? It's because I'm so used to moving around now, a lot more than I used to when I first started playing Warframe. Everything else seems to be sort of slowly not being quick enough, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you're saying you evolved.
Yeah, and I ain't evolved the actual builds or anything to go with me.
Right. Yeah, I was kind of noticing that. Mod used to be like so impressive. Now it's like just breezing through it, just like that much better.
Mm.
Crazy. I can't believe that that same child said it's a child said like you got nerfed. You just evolved them.
Yeah, I mean, it's like some of these, you know, my weapon's supposed to be able to hit them a lot and do a lot of damage really quick, and the only time it's doing it for Wukong is when I'm using his four. But even that doesn't scale. Yay, Wukong rank 27. 3 more levels and he's maxed again. I don't know. Could be better, could be worse. I just need to find that thing that's going to work for me. There we go. I can put that up build now. I'm assuming I ain't got it.
I have it. Yeah, that one. I just don't have him.
Ooh, 424 days login.
$13 that. And with that being said, I'm gonna step out for a minute.
Not a problem, dude. I think I'm actually gonna take a break myself, get a drink, refresh, come back, and kick some ass.
So, let's say we rendezvous like hour.
Yeah, why not?
Alright, so I'll see you by like 8:30. I'll be.
No, well, 8:30. Oh, in an hour. That'll be like half one for me. Half one ain't mine, dude.
Sorry, bro. 8:30 on my side.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna call it, dude. Half one in the morning. All them hours. Seriously? No. I'm coming up to a 3-hour stream, so I'm not going to do overboard like I used to. So I'm going to call it an end. Guys, thank you very much on all platforms for watching. Much appreciated. Hope that you actually choose to come back and watch me again. Don't forget to hit that follow, and then that way you'll know when I'm streaming, which is basically every day. 1 to 2 streams a day, maybe more, depending on the situation. I'm going to call the Warframe stream to an end. And I will see you guys next time. So, enjoy. Bye-bye.
Peace. Alright, so...